Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, it's the world away, and we now got pack 9 of the Agora Models built in 1967 Shelby Super Steak. Now I've got the car here, this is pretty much what we've done at the moment, but we don't really need the car in this one because we're building the engine. Finally, we're building the heart of the car. In fact, there's only one part in this which we need to put in the main car, which is the switch, which I believe operates the headlights, but that's going to be coming soon. But as you can see, up to pack 8, we've done all of this. On the shelf up there, I have got the fender and the doors as well. If you want to get this for yourself, then just follow the link down here to the Agora Models website and you'll be able to subscribe for this from pack 1. They do have an accelerated starter as well, so you can get quite a few packs in one go and get up to the position that I'm up to here. But if you do go to the Agora Models website, you will notice a plethora of other things they've got there. They've got the Terminator T800. They've also got the Cobra, which I'm building, and I'm going to put the video up here for pack 1, which I just completed recently. And you can register your interest now for the Battleship Bismarck, which is coming out in some territories sometime later this month. But without further ado, let's get cracking. Now this pack encompasses stages 65 to 73, and as you can see here, this is the first part that we've got. It's going to be the first parts of the radiator, so we'll get these parts open. So the first part we got is the radiator back, looking like that. We've got the radiator grill here. This radiator grill is metal and it's just going to fit just over the top, just like that. And then we've got a fan bracket looking just like that. Now this is just going to go into the hole in the middle. Once again, there is a shape to this hole, so we just need to push that into there the correct way round, so it fits all the way in, just like that, as you can see. And then we want to turn it over, and we're going to screw that in with an MP01 screw. That's just one of the screws that come in this pack. So I've got that loaded up here. We'll just get that in that hole, and when that's in, it should look just like that. And a nice simple way to start, that's all there is to do in that stage. Now stage 66, we've got the fan to install, so we get this open. Now once again, this comes with MP01 screws, so if you've got any left over from the last stage, you can use that as well. So we're going to take the fan shroud, looking like that, and that's going to go over the top of this grill that we just installed, just in here, just like that. It actually clips itself into place, so you know you've got it the right way around. And we're going to hold this in place just into these four holes that we've got, 1, 2, 3, 4, with the MP01 screws. So I've got those here. Let's get the opposite corners in first, just to hold that into place. Number 2. Number 3 in this corner, and then finally we just got number 4 here. So when that's in, it should look just like that. Now we keep this fan separate from this for this stage, because that's all there is to do in this stage. Now in stage 67, we're going to be assembling the front of the radiator. So we get this open, and the first thing we're going to do is going to take the top of the radiator here. And as you can see, we've got this lovely chrome radiator cap there. That's just going to go into the keyhole design that you got there. So you can only put it in one way. It's going to sit in like that. It's going to be held in with an MP02 screws. Now MP02 screws are really tiny. I'll try and load one of these up just to show you how tiny they actually are. But that's just going to go into this side just to keep that in there. So screwing that nice and tight. Don't over tighten these plastic parts, because you've got a danger of rounding the thread there. So just hand tight would be perfect. And there we go, that's in place. So now we're going to be bringing over the other section of the radiator with the shroud on that we've already done. And this is just going to fit over the lugs that you can just see in there. It should fit flat to that side, as you can see, like that. If it doesn't, spin it round, and then that should fit in place, no problems at all. Now we need to put the other section of the radiator in. As you can see, we've got two little notches. We need to make sure they face down. So when we put this in, it's going to go in just like this. And when they're clipped together, I'm just holding it at the moment. All we've got to do is just put the next bit of grill on, which looks just like this. This is metal as well. And that's just going to go over the top, just like that. And once again, this is going to be held in with MP02 screws just into the tiny holes that we can see there. Now it only takes two screws, this one, and they're in each of the corners. So I'll put this one in first. There we go, that's holding that side in perfectly. We'll just do the same down the bottom here on the opposite corner. Again, make sure that's nice and tightly in. And there you go, that's all there is to do in this stage. Now stage 68, we're starting to build the air filter and carburetor. Quite a lot to do in this stage, so we get all this open. As you can see, loads to do in that. Just take this out first, because this is what immediately springs to my attention. Lovely and metal this is, quite heavy it is. But I'm gonna keep that to one side, because the first thing we need is the start of the air filter. So I'm just getting the parts of the air filter out here. And the first thing you'll notice is we've got the grill here, which is made of metal, which we're going to need to bend round into the channel that you can see inside the air filter there. So with the orange side facing outwards, we're going to be putting that into the channel and then bringing it all the way around the air filter. So it's probably best to keep that flat and just guide your fingers around here. It should stay in on its own. It shouldn't want to ping out. Although saying that, my one just did. But once you've got it all the way around, it should stay in, no problems at all. Just like that. Now we need to just close this up with the top here, and this looks absolutely brilliant. Look at the bling on that. And that's just going to go over the lugs that you can see there, the two holes, line them up and make sure that that metal that we've put round fits in the channel of the top half as well, which it does on my one, just checking that all the way around. If it doesn't, just poke it in with your fingers, that will sit in absolutely fine. And now we're going to be screwing this in with MP01 screws, and I've got two left over from the previous stages here, but they are available in this stage as well. So here's the first one. And when that's in, that should look just like that. Pretty cool, huh? Now we need to install the carburetor top, which looks like that, just underside of the air filter there. So that's just gonna fit in like that. Once again, this is gonna be held in with MP01 screws. So I've got them ready here, let's put them in. Here's the first one. Nice and tight, and one more just on the other side. I do love building the engine here. Such detail. Very similar to the Cobra that we've just built here as well. There we go, nice and tight. Now we're going to be putting this on top of the engine block. Now we do have an aligning lug hole there, which is going to correspond to the hole that you can just see at the top there. So this is just going to go in this way round, turn it upside down, and once again this is going to be held in with MP01 screws. So here's the first one. Holding that into place, and one more just on the other side. That should look like that from underneath, and there we go, that from on top. Now the last thing we need to put in are the valve covers, looking just like this. Now these are metal and they are really heavy. This is what's adding the real quality to the engine. Now at the bottom, as you can see, each one's got a letter. This one says R, this one says L, and it's going to match the corresponding letters that you see on the engine block here, R and L, for right and left. So get these lined up, we put these into place. Now you know where they're going to go, but if it doesn't fit one way, make sure that these lugs just on the end here will fit into the recesses that you can see just there, so it can only fit on one way. Now these are going to be held in with MD06 screws, which I've got here, and I know a lot of you are fans of this when I say this, but I am screwing into metal on this one, and because this engine's looking so nice, I don't want to take the risk. So I am just dabbing a tiny, tiny bit of oil just onto the screw here, so that when I put this in, it's going to go in no problems at all, as you can see there. So I'll do the second side. And there we go, that's the first rocker head cover in. Let's do the same on the other one. or valve cover. I know everyone's got a different name for those. So put that in the way it goes. Just gonna lie it down just while I load a screw up. And here's the second one. And there we go. That's both of the valve head covers in. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 69, we're doing the front housing and we're doing the pressure pump. So I'll get all these out. And this is what all the pieces look like. And I have to point out once again, look, this is metal. I never saw this on the prototype, and the details are immaculate. So what we're going to be doing, first off, we're going to be putting the housing support just over the lugs here. So as you can see, we've got a bigger lug and a smaller lug. They're just going to fit this way around, so it fits flat on the back of that engine there. We're going to be screwing this in with MD06 screws. They do come in this pack. I've got one here already though. I am going into metal again. I don't want to take the risk. Just going to drop that in a touch of oil and screw that down nice and tight. Do the same to the bottom one there. Again, nice and tight, so now that's in, it's not going anywhere. Now we've got to take this tiny part here. Look at that, it's very tiny. I'll show you on the back of my hand. It's got two bushes on the actual detail side which need to face up, but you can orientate it correctly because this is shaped like a D at the bottom there. And that's just going to go into this hole that you can see at the top there. So just revolve it around until it fits into the gap and then push it home, which when it's in should look just like that. We could put that to one side because we're going to be working on the pressure pump now. This is the top of the pump and this is the actual bracket for it. As you can see, we've got a D shaped here as well, so this can only go in one way over that. So I'm going to line that up and put that in, pushing it down. Oops, dropped it. So that looks just like that. Then this is going to fit on the housing that we've just done. As you can see, we've got a larger hole there and we've got a locating lug hole there, which is going to match this exactly, as you can see, just like that. So I line this up and put this into place. So that's coming off the side like that. Turn it over. And then this is going to be held in with an MP01 screw. So I've got that here. Just going to push this into the hole. Keep that into place. Make it nice and tight. There we go. And now that's into place, looking like that. And that is all there is to do in this stage. Now, as you can see here, stage 70 is radiator hoses. We've got the pulleys here, and we've also got the alternator, which is this here. We've also got some MP01 screws. So the first thing we need to do is we need to assemble the alternator. This is just the alternator housing here. Again, it's just going to go over to the D shape you just see on that section there. That's going to match there. So I'll line this up and we'll get this into place. Push it home hard as you can get it. There we go. And that's the alternator in place. Then we're going to be doing exactly the same thing, but with the hoses here, we've got three lugs, three pegs. We're just going to push these together. So we've got one complete radiator hose. So line them up and push them together. They shouldn't need glue. You don't need to glue this. And there we go. That's the radiator hosed, pushed into place. One end's going to have a peg on it then. One end's got a vacant round section there. Now we're going to take the engine front housing here with the pressure pump that we put on there. And we're going to be putting the alternator just on the other side here for the opening you see. Once again, we've got a locating lug and a big hole. That's going to match what we've got just there on the alternator. So put that in just like that. Turn it over. Once again, that's going to be held in with an MP01 screw. We're then going to be attaching the pulleys and the fan blade. So we need the pulleys and we also need the fan blade that we had from the previous issue. Now the large section of the pulley here is going to fit over that central spindle there, and then the smaller one's just going to fit over the alternator there. So when this is on, it's going to look just like that. We're going to be putting the fan on top of this section here, making sure this is orientated correctly. So basically the fins should be pointing outwards from this, just like that there. Then turn it over. We're going to hold this all into place here with an MP01 screw just down the center there. And when that's in, that's all in place just like that. Now it does say you should be able to turn this with some resistance, as you can see there, the blade can turn just like that. The last thing to do is just to bring back the radiator that we've got here. As you can see, we've got a hole at the top with a semi-circular hole on there. All we're going to do is we're going to put that D shape from the hose into this hole to keep the radiator housing in place, or the radiator pipe in place, should I say. So that looks just like that. And that, with this section here, is all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 71, we're working on the engine block, right exhaust manifold, and the light switch. So this is where we're going to need the vehicle when we put the light switch in, but I'll get all this out. Once again, you heard that funk there. That was basically this great big metal engine block that we've got here. So let's get this out. I do love how this looks, and I said it's very heavy as well. I do love this at all. We've got some numbers on there, which is going to help us with the manifolds there. But what we're going to be putting on is the gas filter, which looks just like that. And this is just going to go into the hole that you can see here. Once again, we've got a locating lug there. So we put that, push that in. That sits just over the top there. And we're going to secure this in from the other side with an MP03 screw. Now, these screws come in this pack. They've got a slight flange on them, as you can see. So I'll drive that home. And that's the gas filter into place. Now, we can just push all of this to the other side because we need the light switch. Now, that looks just like this on the wire, and I'm hoping you can see this on the side camera, but we have got a little gap just at the top here where this light switch is going to go into place. So we want to locate it so that the two wires at the top are facing upwards at the top, so we've got a blank wire down the bottom there, and we're going to push it into the hole that we've got vacant just next to at the top section there. Now, it sort of holds itself into place there. Now, I have taken the camera off just so you can see how that goes, but it holds itself into place there quite easily. And then with the holes that you can see just at the side of it, we're actually going to be putting this tiny detail here into place, screwing it in from the one hole in the middle that's going to keep that switch into place. Now, once again, that's going to be held in with an MPO through screw. So I'll get that all lined up, ready to go first, and we'll keep this into place now. And when that's in, that should look just like that. That's all we need for the vehicle in this one, so let's go back to building the engine. So the first thing we need is the pipe connector, and as you can see, we have got numbers on this, which is going to help us align the pipes. Now, the manifold pipes are actually labeled just at this end here. So what we want to do first is we're going to need a number, well, it don't matter what way we put these around, I guess. I'm just checking what I've got here. We've got the very short one first, which is labeled R1. So that's just going to go into the top like that. Next one I've got here is R2, which is going to go next to it over here. Now, they have got different ways to go around. So you keep turning it until the lug actually fits into the gap, just like that. Then we've got R3. God, I'm doing this without, there's R3 in. And last but not least, we've got R4, doing this without my glasses. So how cool is that? And there's number 4 in. So when it's done, they should all look just like that. And basically, that's all there is to do in that stage. So stage 72, we're going to be doing the left engine block and the left exhaust manifolds. We've got some MD06, we've got a bracket, we've got the manifolds there, and we've got another heavy engine block looking like that. So the first thing we're going to do, exactly like last time, we've got the pipe connector here. We're going to put the pipes in where they go. And as you can see now, that's the mirror to the right-hand side one looking like that. Now we're going to start piecing the engine together. So we need this left block that we got here, and we need this housing that we worked on in the previous stage. And we're going to be assembling it just on this side of the engine here with three notches that you can see at the top. So the two slots that we've got made by this black bracket here are just going to fit into these slots. So they just go in and slide down just like that. And that's holding that into place there. Then we've got a gearbox part, which top of the gearbox here, which has got a sloping section just like that there. That's going to fit down this slot here on this side. And basically the semicircle is going to be facing down towards the rear or the base of this fan section here. So then we're going to take the other side here, probably best on the top camera. We're going to piece all of these together so that the slot that we can see on the top of the gearbox housing there is going to go down that slot. And the other two slots that we've got on that black detail there are going to go into these points here. So let's push this together. This is going to look pretty impressive. Give it a good squeeze to get it all in. Make sure nothing's out and there's no gaps. And there we go. That's all into place like that. And that's going to be held into place with these four holes on the right-hand side of the engine here. And they are MD06 screws. So I'll get them open. And I will be using some oil on this because this is quite a heavy part. I want to make sure this is held absolutely perfectly. Oopsie-daisies. So let's get the first one in. That's the first one in. I'll do the top left one next. Then the top right. And then the bottom left. And then tighten these as tight as I can get them. And as you can see, that's that side in. And that's what the front of it looks like. Now we're going to be putting the manifold sections in. So the right hand one's going to go into the right hand side. The left hand's going to go into the left hand side. So I'm going to put the right manifolds in first. They're just going to go into the holes here. So I've got that over here looking like that. We'll just line that up and push them into the holes. So R4, R3, R2, and R1. And that's the right-hand side manifold done. We complete that with the left-hand side. So once again, I've got the left side here. I'm just gonna turn that around and put this into place. So once again, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And there we go, that's those two manifolds into place on each side there. Now we need to take the bracket, which is going to fit underneath the radiator here, and those two lugs that we can see underneath the radiator, they're going to go through these holes here. So push that into place. 1 and 2. That's only a push to fit, we don't need to glue that, but that's done. And then basically with this and this, that's the end of that stage. Now the last stage, stage 73, is just the engine block bottom, the oil cooler, and the connection cable. So get all these bits out, just like that. You heard that thud again there. It does make me laugh, that does. It shows you the quality of these engine parts here. And we've got a little metal plate here. I'm going to get that open. And we've got some tiny details in this pack as well that I'll just keep to one side. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to be taking the engine block bottom that we worked on last time. We're going to mirror this now with the top. So when we do that, the section that says Cobra is going to be facing towards the fan. We've got two massive lugs here, which are going to go right through the center of that block there. Pushing that home. And there we go. That's complete. Look at that. That looks absolutely amazing already. That's just mirrored those sections together. Then we're going to turn it upside down and we've got the bottom of the engine here. And as you can see, this can only go on one way. It's going to fit just like that. And it's all going to be held into place there with two MD06 screws. And there we go. That's the engine almost looking complete. Look at that. It's so heavy. Okay, I'm going to put that to one side because what we're going to do next is we're going to have the oil cooler and connection cable. These two are going to be mirrored together here. So we've got a lug section here, but we want the flat section at the bottom. That's just going to go in here and we just push that home. It should seat itself in, no problems at all like that. And that's just going to fit into the hole at the top of the engine just there. So line it up because it's got a D-shaped sort of connector on that and push that home. Just like that. That again holds itself in, no problems at all. Now we've got another small detail here, again with a D-shaped connector that's going to go next to it. In the D-shaped hole there, we just push that in just like that. Then we've got this massive cable section. This cable is plastic, but one end is going to fit into the hole that we can just see on the top of the gearbox there. So I'm just going to push that in. The other side is just going to fit over the nipple that you can see just on top there. So I'll get that lined up. So that looks just like that. I can put that to one side as we just work on the oil cooler there. And so this is the front of the cooler here. We're just gonna marry it up with the rear section of the cooler, just like this, making sure that we align the lugs. Turn it around. Just like that. So now that's one complete unit in there. And then at the side that we've got the four tiny screw holes there, we're actually going to be putting the metal plate just over the top of it like that. And we're going to be screwing that down with some MP07 screws. These are really tiny screws, these ones. And we've got four of these to put into place. So I'll line that up. We'll get these in. You're probably going to need small magnifying glass, I reckon. Because, they are very, very tiny. If you don't believe me, check that out. Okay, let's get all of these in. And there's the fourth one going in, no problems. So that should look just like that. And then quite simply, the oil filter is going to fit onto the two holes at the bottom of this side of the radiator with a metal plate facing outwards. So we just push it into these holes, into position, do this side as well. And there we go, that's actually going to hold itself into place there. And with the radiator completed, which is pretty much going to go sort of like this, that is all there is to do in this pack. And can I say, oh my God, that is amazing. It's heavy, it's metal, it looks so impressive. What do you reckon of that, huh? I'm so happy with that. That was an absolute pleasure to build. Now, I saw the engine on the prototype, but on the prototype, it was all plastic. I haven't seen the detail that we've got here. And I know a lot of you were concerned about that when you did see the prototype. Trust me, I'm sure if you look at that now, it is pretty amazing. I just love the weight of it. I can't wait to get this into the car. Now, pack 10 is going to be coming out next month, hopefully. I am going to do a little bit of a check of the electrics before then. So when I do that, I'm going to show you how I do, just to make sure all those switches are working, because as we start to enclose the car, the last thing we want to do is put the bodywork in and realize that we've got a loose connection somewhere. But if you like what I've done here today and you want to subscribe to this yourself, just head on over to the Agora Models website. You can subscribe to this from pack 1. And as I said, there is an accelerated starter for this, so you can get yourself near to the stage that I'm at the moment. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.